Good evening and once again welcome to another Bus Constructor development stream. As you may know, this is going to be the last stream for a few weeks because I won't be around, unfortunately. And today we are going to do several bug fixes, and I basically plan to play the game a bit and find out stuff that's not, you know, working as expected, or stuff that isn't working properly, bugs and general accessibility problems, and maybe also a bit of balancing depending on what we find today. Alright, so I'm going to go right into it, and this was written in the forums in the issue and bug section. So yeah, let's fix these. So why do we have reinforced decorations if they still only have one HP? Well, that's correct. So basically, decorations, if I remember correctly. This is the wrong decoration. The correct decoration. Yeah, they are all really cheap and really, really light. So it doesn't really make too much sense to have different attributes for decorations. I sort of wonder what the best way would be to fix this. So we have this add attribute function, which basically assigns new attributes to modules. Yeah, this would be one way to fix it. So we could basically just filter the list of modules which could have attributes. So basically we could make decoration modules not have attributes. Yeah, because actually none of these really make sense for them. Okay, we just have to do some testing afterwards, because I'm not too sure if it won't have any side effects if we just remove the possibility to have attributes, but we will find out. So attribute common, attribute. Alright. Alright, so basically we're just going to override this function for decorations and replace it with a function that doesn't really do anything, just sets the attribute to null, and well, that shouldn't really be required either, but for safety let's leave it in. Okay, now the question is, what will happen if you try to assign an attribute here in the Gambler? Well, I guess it would be safest to just have them not appear here. Okay, so basically that we filter the list of modules in the inventory and skip the ones which are decorations. Seems reasonable. Okay, so skip AM instance of decoration. Alright. I'm not totally sure if I if I am aware of all the possible ways this could have gone wrong, but yeah, that should be pretty much that. Okay, so let's begin some new patch notes. Okay. Tributes. All right. That would be one fix. Okay, next let us fix the invalid placement warning, which is always present and which is caused by, I think, okay, by default it is always true. Okay, yeah, I think I know what the reason is. So again, the wrong decoration class. Again, the wrong decoration class. Here. Yes, no. Yes. Okay. Let's see. Okay, yeah. So basically, the problem here is that the decoration, when it is in the inventory, doesn't have an actual ship part, and hence it returns false, but it should actually return true in that case. So, yeah. Okay. That should be that. Okay, so let's test these. A shop resets every time I enter the galaxy map. Yeah, that is true. I guess he means the galaxy shop. We will test that soon. Okay, decorations, invalid placement. Let's test it. Has gone wrong here. Attribute equal null from attribute class decoration. Decoration. Oh, again, we accidentally took the wrong class. Okay, that should fix that. Yeah, and that should also fix the other problem. Hey, Zodox, Yeah, I guess I'm a coder. Yeah, I also do some graphics and music and yeah, general game development stuff. Instance of decorations. Reference decoration is ambiguous. Okay. Decoration is the correct one. What? I haven't really used C sharp too much. I have programmed in C++ a long time ago, but yeah, it's actually really long ago, so I'm no longer any good at C++ or C sharp, I think. It is loading, let's also update the date. August. Could actually try to update the background image based on the new artwork which we have. Oh, by the way, actually, I can show you two new artworks which are now complete for the game. First one you may already know if you've watched the last week's stream. And we have a new one, which is this one. I really like it. Really like it. And if you've watched the stoppage lately, I've already used it on some places to, you know, as a new capsule graphic in the shop, for example. Here, I can show you like this, for example. And I'm really looking forward to have more of these graphics done and added to the game. It will be mainly relevant for the story mode, but which I will also use as a general, you know, for general stuff. Like trailer, marketing materials, and so on. All right. First of all, I should probably disable music because it will likely sound really strange on stream. And next, let's check if the decoration stuff is working. So, okay, so I guess it's best to go to decoration mode, exploration mode, and see what the stores are doing. Okay, so we do have decorations here for sale, which may or may not be a good idea. So let's sell some stuff. Okay, but all of these decorations do not have any attributes, which makes sense. Which is what we've just done, and which is good. I'm not really a big fan of having so much decorations here in the shop. So maybe I might want to turn down the probability on those a bit. I'm not sure. I mean, it's not a huge issue, but it is sort of crowding out the other modules, which is sort of unfortunate. So yeah, let's just either decrease the probability for the Galaxy Store, or just add more modules there in general. Okay, so GameStud Exploration shop. Unlocked stuff, shop, tech lab, shop. Okay. Okay, so apparently the procedure where the inventory of the shop is created is in the shop class itself. Get inventory. If inventory null, create a new inventory. Okay, and to create 100 items. Okay. Okay, so I guess in order to counteract the decorations which have entered the game, I'm just going to increase the total number of modules on sale. Yeah. Which brings me to another point. Yeah. So basically, many players are not aware of this, and I don't really blame them because it's not very apparent from how it looks in the game. But researching stuff increases the stuff that is available on the Galaxy Map Store. And currently it's not really apparent and it's not really visible, but I want to make it visible actually. So,
Galaxy map
first of
initialized.
all, let's check.
Trade interface
Okay, so the
activated.
overall number of modules has increased, which is good. Decoration. Okay. Good. Okay. So first of all, let's do that. So what I want to do is I want to increase. Wait a second. Second. Think my PC is getting really hot again. Which I want to prevent as much as possible because it's already terribly warm in here. Could also turn on the light in a second. Yeah, other than that, killing Dropbox should fix the issue at least a bit, I hope. Okay. Okay, right. Right. Okay, so rather than okay, so rather than have them not appear on the store, I'm going to make them appear and I want to avoid this to have any side effects, so I'm not entirely sure how to best do this. Okay, so I guess I'm going to make a second list, which is locked modules. Okay, yeah. Locked modules is also a list of modules, and if a module is not researched yet, we are going to add it to the list of locked modules. That should be pretty fail-safe. Locked modules add, yeah, okay. Should actually work like this. So now when we list all the modules. So here is the inventory of the shop. We will just check if So basically, we are going to make them be disabled if they are not researched yet. Okay, so if shop left module is not null and shop locked modules contains AM, then we are going to disable the button. Okay. Ideally, we would also want to add like a tooltip, which explains why it cannot be bought yet. But well, we'll see. Okay. Okay, let's see if it works. So now a whole lot should be disabled. Yeah. Okay, let's set some stuff. It's a bit I don't know. It's a bit unfortunate that it gets really, really hard to see in a way, because there's just so much stuff flying around. So I'm not really sure if that's such a good change, to be honest. So we have legendary targeting laser. Should really turn on the light in a second. It's actually a sort of hard question. I mean, if I do not include these in the list. So what would be more intuitive for the player? Well, I mean, normally you have like stuff which you can see on offer, but some of the stuff is locked. Okay, yeah. Okay, in either way, we will add like a tooltip which explains what is happening and why it is locked. And maybe, I don't know, wait a second. What is. Expand the trader supply by liberating shops and tech labs. It's actually sort of clear from the tooltip. Okay, so I guess I'm going to undo this change because it doesn't really add too much, I think. Yeah, okay. And it actually makes it really messy to work with these shops in the beginning. All right. So let's just undo everything. Okay. There is another issue regarding the shops which was pointed out, which is that The offer changes every time you click it. And I'm not sure, but we can check. So now we have an anti-grav targeting laser. If we enter again, we still have it. Now if we enter the editor and go back, it is gone. Yeah, that's correct. That's actually a bug. I mean, there is sort of a larger scale bug, which is if you save, quit, and load the game again, it will be gone, or it will be reset the shop. But that's sort of a long-term issue, which I'm not going to fix now. But I think it should at least be consistent while we are in the same sector and we do not exploit this in a way. All right. So, why is that happening? So we have shop equals shop. Shop equals new shop. Okay. And that's actually not it. Enter. Okay, so every time we enter the galaxy map, a new shop is created. And I guess that should no longer happen. So instead, we're going to make a function which is update shop. And basically, we are going to do this only if shop is null. Actually, that shouldn't even be required. Actually, if we think really good, really hard about when we should do this, it shouldn't be a problem. So, if we load a game, and this stuff is happening, and in the end, it should update the shop. Okay, likewise, when we complete a mission. Can we check for this? Well, if we have an exploration mission and we warp out, enter, execute win. Okay. Okay. Unlocking stuff. Enemy ship destroyed. Player ship destroyed. I'm not sure if leaving it will trigger the correct function. Okay. Okay, warp out, set game state, warp out target, okay. Warp out target, okay. Okay, that should actually work. So we are just going to append the warp out function and add game state exploration update shop. Okay, that should pretty much fix it, I think. Put it up there with the rest. And we should actually also make it static. All right. So let's test it. Alright, so now we have an ultralight energy chain. Let's go to the editor. We still have it, okay. Now let's see if it updates when we... Whoops. sort of a hard game which we have here. Something easier. So basically we'll need to anti-grav solar panel. Basically we'll need to... What has happened here actually? Ah, okay, it's one of the save games. Let's actually create a new game and test it. Let's make it a very simple chip.
Galaxy map initialized.
Let's add these missile launchers. And it's all sort of hard. Move asteroids to lab. Collect weapon fragments. This is probably the easiest one, so let's do this one. And we already have a few fragments over here. Was pretty easy. Some more fragments here. Actually easier than expected, so let's collect the remaining stuff. I guess at some point I will have to save the content of the Galaxy Store. Might actually do it this time as well in this patch, because it's sort of a long time issue which is well, it's sort of exploitable. I mean it's not like a super competitive game, so I'm not really concerned about players exploiting stuff which makes them enjoy the game more, but still. Alright, so let's see. We had the ultralight solar panel and it's gone now. Well, it's not exactly gone, there's still an ultralight solar panel, but there are more modules now, so that should be fixed now. Okay, so let me turn on the light. It's getting really dark here. Also get something more to drink. Alright, so next on our to-do list, let's try to make the shop offer persistent when we save grid and reload the game. Which, let's just make sure, it is not now. It is clearly not at the moment. Okay, but first let's finish this thread. An ally attacked and killed me for no reason. He also spawned on the exit, so I completed the mission immediately. But maybe I could hit him by accident, I don't know. Alright, good. Let's do this and let's move this to the archive. And let's go back. Change it. Actually, still some bugs, some of which are here in this list, and some which I have written down elsewhere. Okay, but first, let's do the. Yeah. Let's do the shop saving. So basically, when we save the game, which is done here. We will have to save the shop inventory as well. Okay, so let's do it. Okay, so let's see how it is done in the ship exporter. Load module, get as properties. Okay, get as properties and number. Okay. Okay. And load module restores it. Okay. Okay, it's actually easy enough. So we can just use this function which we have already written. Or is it? Because it is like a properties thingy. Properties ship. Okay, so we create a new property thing. And then, okay, we put the module number there. Okay, that should actually work if we just create a property object and then save the property object. Okay, let's try it. So, props is new properties. And then we save the okay. Object props. And then I will just have to look at the shop itself. So if the shop is not null. And shop inventory is not null. Then we set this property to module count to shop inventory size. And then we're just going to cycle through all of these modules. Alright. Should actually be pretty straightforward. Assuming that it works like this, of course. We'll test it in a second, but before we do that, we can also add the loading code. It will not work yet, of course, because the existing save files do not have this done. But, yeah. Okay, so let's have a look at here. Load, 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 load. Properties. Okay, yeah, just take the properties from the file. Object. Okay. And then we just check if wait a second. What do I do here? Okay, so it's just if the shop is not existing for some reason, we will just set it to zero so that we can check it later on. Okay. Size is props get properties plus int. Okay, like this. Okay. Load module properties num. Okay. Good, 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 good. Okay, so if the size is greater than zero, we will take the shop's inventory and create a new inventory. Yep, like this. And then we're going to fill this inventory with the modules which we have just saved. So am ship exporter load module. And we give it the properties and the number. Alright. And then we just add it to the inventory. And it should actually sort of work. There are probably still a few bugs, but actually, that should largely solve it, I think. Set property, get as properties, okay. Needs to be ship exporter. Let's try it. Problem here. apparently has some sort of parsing error. I'm not really sure why. Okay, let's check the stuff that we changed. Change this part. Okay, maybe there's a problem here. Okay, let's try it like this. Just trying to locate this error. Okay, it works now. So apparently this is where the problem was. Ah, okay, yeah. All right. Or maybe not. Okay. Okay, yeah, that was probably the issue here. I forgot to indent it properly after the for command. And it's still not working. So strange. This, probably a mistake caused by the mJava preprocessor, which is sometimes just a bit strange. What the hell? But I don't get it. Didn't this solve the issue? Just removing this stuff? Actually did. So I'm presuming that this part is the problem. But if I remove this stuff, okay, it's probably this part which isn't working. Okay, I get it. I get it. Yeah. Okay, that was actually my mistake. Paste error. Okay, good. Okay. Let's test it. So basically, now the offer should be maintained when we restart the game. Okay, so we have a robust solar panel. Let's sort of remember that. And let's exit. And let's load it again.
Galaxy map initialized.
And we have
tray of interface
robust
activated.
solar panel, excellent. Just to make sure, let's restart it. I'm actually sort of amazed that this worked without any problems. I sort of expected at least some sort of bugginess and some sort of crashes and incompatibilities and stuff. But I guess.
Galaxy map initialized.
Nice!
Interface activated.
Nice! Very nice. And it's actually sort of a bug which has been on my to-do list for a long, long time, so I'm sort of happy that it is done. Just a minor thing, I think I want to have the decorations at the end of the list and not mixed in with the rest. So let's look at how the sorting is done. Oui. Okay. What? This looks like absurdly complicated. Okay, let's just do it very simple. If am instance of decoration, then return plus one or minus one. I'm not really sure, but we will see. And if this is instance of decorations, we will return minus one. So now it will be either the front of the list or at the end of the list, and we will see. Good. Okay, I guess it is sorted by attribute first and by name second. And since the decorations are all common and are all, what? Inconvertible types? Yeah. I really shouldn't have two classes which have the same name. I wonder. I wonder if it's worth the trouble to change it. But actually, I don't think there's going to be too much decoration-specific stuff in the future, so it's probably more work to rename it than to just accept it in silent despair. That didn't do anything. Why did that do nothing? Isn't the list sorted? I mean, it apparently it isn't sorted, but it should be sorted. Okay. Shop, get inventory, collection, sort inventory. That is sort of strange. Ah, okay. Okay. It isn't sorted because the list was saved from in the file. So it will be sorted when I start a new game or when I load a game where inventories are not saved yet. Okay. Okay. Good. Good, good. Headshots. So. Okay, so let's make open a second game. And okay, so it was exactly the other way around. Okay, good. But That should be fixed now when we just reverse the sign here. Nice, okay. So that should be pretty much done. Let's have a look if there are more things which we can change right now. Okay, the R9-290, I'm not sure if that's fixed now. Ship parts are not drawn. Okay. Okay, it's actually sort of an old issue, so it may be fixed already, and if it's not, I'm sort of pretty late to answer to it. Sort of forgot that one. I don't know. Really strange. All right, never mind. Yeah, I think I have a few more things to fix. Not here. Let's just copy this stuff. And see what we can do. Okay, progress report. Some other stuff. Okay, it's sort of messed up here. All right. Yeah, stuff appearing in the upper left corner. Weird graphical artifacts, the smoke from damaged ship modules and item modules will appear in the upper left of the map. I know this more commonly happens with missions with freighters and mining ships. Yeah, that is actually sort of a known bug, and why not fix it? I mean, it's not like a major game-breaking bug, and that's also the reason why I didn't fix it yet, but we could at least give it a try. Okay, so basically, when ship parts get damaged, okay, there is a bit of smoke there. Okay, so it didn't trigger here. Okay, so let's try to find the conditions which have to be fulfilled for this bug to trigger. Let's just sort of damage that guy a bit. Let's see if smoke has appeared here. Oh, okay. What is that?
Module connected.
It looks a bit like particle effects. I'd like to see sort of the trigger for this, but okay, it seems to be the explosions from the missiles, I think. Okay, let's see if that can be true. So basically, explode. I wonder, is it explode? Note. Wait, what happens when a shot hits something? So we have contact handler. Shots against everything. A shot, if it is not destroyed, we do all sort of damaging stuff. And in the end, okay, shot explode. And we give it a vector, px, py, which should be sort of the point of the collision. Okay. But for some reason, that doesn't really work. Well, let's just have a look. So first of all, let's have a look at the position, which we have there. And let's have a look at the px and py, which should be the position of the actual shot, which should actually be sort of the same thing, to be honest. So I'm not really sure what's going on there. What is explosion? Second. Yeah, let's give it a try. And we can also check if the explosion or the particle explosion is the problem. I presume it's this one, but well, we will see. We can also make this a bit more concise. Okay. Oh, actually, there's a lot of debug stuff going on here, which we can probably kill. Cannot find. Oh, it's position, not positions. Hi, Sonessy. Well, I haven't really streamed it around from the start, but I'm doing this for quite a while now. You can have a look at my YouTube if you like. There should be like several days of streaming entertainment if you like. But no, the game was already on Steam Early Access when I started streaming. So I guess I've been streaming for like half a year or a bit longer than that probably. But okay, so let us. Okay, so first of all, we should remove these debugging stuff, which is sort of annoying. Okay, and then. Okay. Okay. So the positions seem to be correct, but nevertheless, there is stuff drawn in the top left corner. Okay, let's see. Okay, so before I forget, let's remove this debug output stuff, which we just noticed. What? 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 Oh, it's dist, not diff. All right. Spawn to. Okay, yeah. That was pretty much a debug output from the time when I implemented this new algorithm for ship placement, but that should be considered done now, so it's no longer required. Okay, so I'm guessing the particle explosion is the problem. Let's go to particle explosion. And I have no idea. I have literally no idea. Just before we go into that, let's make sure that it is not the explosion that is causing the problem. Thanks for subscribing. I will probably make another progress report video later this week. Unfortunately, I won't be able to stream next week and the week after, but yeah, I should still be able to make a short progress video to show what I've been working on lately. What were we doing? Okay, let's just have a look. Oh. And actually, there's still stuff going on here, okay. Does it even have to do with this stuff? I wonder. Let's see. Okay. Some of this is actually happening regardless of the other stuff. This is super weird, actually. So apparently it is appearing when I first fire the shot. So maybe then it doesn't have to do with the explosion effects here. I'm going to leave them disabled for a while, just to exclude this as a possible source of problems. So instead I'm going to assume that it is the shot itself which is causing the problem. Okay, so... Okay, so basically here we are calculating the position of the shot. Okay, I think I might know what the problem is. So basically when we create a particle emitter, we have to set its position before we create any particles. I mean, it's pretty straightforward actually, but maybe since we changed the particle system, this isn't working in the correct order. Yeah, so that is probably the assumption I'm going to go with. So let's have a look at abstract scene with particle emitter. Just to be clear, I started to change the particle system the game is using a few weeks ago, and the transition isn't fully done yet, so different parts of the game have different particle systems, which isn't making life much easier, honestly, and which I'm going to have to change at some point. So I'm going to have to unify the different particle systems, which should also prevent bugs like this from occurring. Okay, so okay. So if I remember correctly, this particle system already has a position parameter which can be set like in an XML file or so, and which we'll probably have to manually set before we do the remaining stuff. This is actually more annoying than I thought. Actually, way more annoying than I thought. Okay, angular offset, value, velocity, set position. Okay. And basically, we will have to set the position before we create this particle emitter. Or alternatively, well, actually, there might be an alternative because we could just go and reduce the spawn count. Yeah, that might actually be an easy workaround. So basically, the spawn count is the number of particles which are spawned, you know, right in the beginning. And if we just remove those, let's see. It may look sort of strange though. I mean, there was sort of a reason why I added it to the game. Let's see. Actually, now we need a ship with fireballs like this.
Begin mission.
What? Okay, now there are simply no particle effects at all. Spawn interval, spawn count. Oh, okay. So I guess it means like. That's strange. Distance. Okay, that is probably not the way to go. So apparently there isn't a specific spawn amount on frame 0, but it comes organically through the particle system. In that case, we'll have to set the position before. Okay, let's do a few more tests. So first of all, particle effects are now back for the fireball. But there are also particles here in the top left. Okay. Okay, so let's try something. Let's set the position before we add the emitter, like this. And let's just set it to like 50-50. 50-50 should be one of these grid plane squares to the bottom right. just to see if we can affect it this way.
Begin mission.
Interestingly enough, it works for some, but not for all. It's really strange. Okay, so let's first let's fix the one which we can change, which is here. So basically, we will have to get a position before we do the rest. I mean, we could just take the position as an additional argument. Let's just see how many we have. We have debris, more debris, and shots. Oh, that should actually work. We can actually do that. Can actually do that. Oh, maybe we cannot. Because this is sort of messy. Okay, I'm going to take a different approach. Okay, I'm going to take a different approach, and to be precise, I am going to add the emitter only after we edit it to the. We only add the emitter when we are in the main game loop. That sounds like a reasonable idea. Okay, so I'm going to make Boolean, which I'm going to call slick emitter edit to world. Going to set it to false, and I'm going to take this stuff and put it here in the main execute function. Okay, and if not slick emitter edit world, we are going to edit and set it to true. Seems reasonable, I think. Let's give it a try. What? Okay. Honestly, please don't ask why I have to do this. This is another mJava artifact. Okay, let's see. Okay. Well, you can see it, but wait, actually, I can move the ship over so that I can show you. So it no longer seems to trigger when I hit the shot, only when they disappear. For some reason. That is odd. So basically we fixed half the issue. Now we have to deal with the other half. And it's sort of strange. What is happening actually when we So we have added this stoppable emitter, which was our custom implementation, which allows us to stop a particle. Okay, and if we do stop it, we set the speed to 0. Okay, so let's see if stopping is the problem. Okay, apparently it is. Apparently it is. Which I don't really understand, because all I do is to set the speed to 0. It shouldn't actually change the position, I think. Which is really strange. Let's see, do I have the source code here? Not really. Particle set speed 0. Ah, I see, maybe. Ah, okay. This may be because I'm using the API wrong. Slick javadoc particle. Let's see. Oops. Set velocity. What? What have I been doing? Hit the correct class. Slick particles particle. Okay, now I have this slick particles particle and I set speed to 0. Okay, so apparently it has a set speed and set velocity. I mean, this is a really stupid question, but what is the difference between speed and velocity? Let's see. Set the current speed of the particle. Set the velocity of the particle. Okay, apparently there is a difference and people are. Okay. So I'm sorry, I have to figure out basic concepts. Distance and displacement meanings. Speed is a scalar quantity that refers to how fast an object is moving. The rate at which an object covers distance. Velocity is a vector quantity that refers to the rate at which an object changes its position. Sort of seems the same to me, to be honest. Distance traveled divided by time of travel is speed, and displacement over time is velocity. Well, I don't know. I don't even know. But we can try set velocity instead of set speed. And funnily enough, we also have set velocity, which includes speed. Okay. All right. So let's just try to use set velocity instead of set speed. I mean, in a way, I don't know why it should solve the problem, but we'll see. I mean, it's really strange, right? I mean, I do not really change the position by setting the speed, right?
Begin mission.
All right. But apparently that is a difference, okay? All right. I have no idea why, but apparently problem solved. Okay, let's try against some enemies to see if it also works in real life conditions, so to speak. Ah, okay, it looks strange because I disabled the explosions. Okay. Okay, and there's still some stuff appearing in the top left corner, I think. But it's no longer the shots which we have fixed now. Alright. So, that should be fixed now. Let's go back and restore the explosion effects. And let's add it to the patch notes. Okay. Okay. Let me just get a bit of water and then we're going to do the next bun. Hey Stibrit, good evening. Good to see you. I am sort of good to go for one or two more bugs. Okay. Impossible is too easy. Well, we're going to have to find out. This may or may not be a bug, but I'm playing on impossible difficulty and the game seems easy. In fact, I have some easy missions up here. The game was started after we found and fixed the bug that the game was not saving difficulty. Okay, we also have shops are useless. Module trade on the exploration scheme. Very little available in the shops, and I'm not sure. Okay. Yeah, that's actually not so much a bug, it's more like I didn't really explained well how it works, and that should actually be fixed by now. There is also a bug concerning the Tesla gun, which I'm going to do at a later point probably because it's not so exciting to do, so exciting to find. No, but actually we can try to do that. We can give it a try. Okay, so basically, the player reporting this gave me a save file, which I could use to replicate bug How's it going? Well, so-so. Sort of not getting too much progress in lately, unfortunately. Largely because I'm having some, health issues actually, which is also why I'm not going to be streaming next week and in 2 weeks' time. But I'm, sort of confident that things are improving eventually, and until then,
Talks not
I'm mainly
initialized.
going to focus on bug fixes. What an interesting ship. Okay, so this is actually a ship sent to me by a player. So I'm sort of going to have to find out how it works. Wait a second, what did he write? Q1 to fire with the other cannons when I press the plus button. Well, it may be the plus button for him, but it is not for me because I have another key binding set up. Oh, by the way, actually, I should make it so that the keys highlight when you hover over a module. Oh, that might actually be a nice thing to do. So when you're in the key control binding thing, currently it highlights the modules when you hover over a key binding. At least it should do so. Actually, it could even highlight the modules themselves. Oh, actually, we can do something here, I feel. To make it more apparent what's going on. Okay, let's do that. Let's do that instead. So, game state editor. And, what is it? I think it is called key bubbles or so? No. Bubble overlay. Alright, so we have bubbles which are rendered here. Just have to get an overview myself, and we have render links, get bubble. If HL, okay. HL is highlight. Okay, so basically we have bubbles, and every bubble has a module list. Yeah, okay. And we could actually use that to color the modules. Let's try that. Let's try that. So let's go to the editor. Okay, render UI. If view equals keys, okay, let's steal that and put it here. Okay, render warnings, render key highlights. And we do this only when we are in the keys mode. And then we are going to do this only if modules list is not null. And then, okay, this is actually rather straightforward, if it's correct. If that makes sense. So let's steal this code. Where is it? Go here. This little mosquito flying around. She's going to be a little bit annoying. So let's cycle through the list of modules. And let's see. Oh, it's actually not modules, it's bubbles. Okay. And it's actually also not a bubble which we get, but... Okay, we don't get a module, but we get a bubble. Okay, and we only take the bubbles which are highlighted, which is HL, if I could remember correctly. Is it highlight? Highlight 2? What is highlight 2? Okay, so it is either highlight or highlight 2. I don't know what the difference is, because it's quite a long time ago when I wrote this function. But we'll find out. Okay, and then we're going to go through the list of all the modules which are in this bubble. So, bubble.modules. Oh, actually not. Okay, it's a tiny bit more complicated. It's like this. Okay, good. Good. Now we just have to find out the correct color for our highlight. Get value. Okay, get value is a color, apparently. Okay, that makes it sort of easy. Alright, let's find out if it is that simple. Highlight is not public in bubble. Oh god. All right. And I guess modules is... Okay, that was just incorrect. It is bubble.modules.entryset. Okay. Okay, modules is not public either. Alright, so now it's actually surprisingly, it actually worked surprisingly well. It actually worked surprisingly well. The only problem is that it is too opaque, I think. I wanted to have it slightly transparent, but it's probably something which we can fix pretty easily. All right. So let's just make it transparent. Right, gel color for eye cannot be found. Yeah. I sort of know, but okay, so then let's do it like this. Sort of wanted to avoid this, but I guess I don't quite know why this color class returns these integer values from 1 to 255, which is usually not what you want when you are in like an OpenGL environment where you usually always have these mathematical 0 to 1 ranges. Well, whatever. All right. Pretty nice. Pretty nice. Okay. Now I only want to add the reverse way. So when I hover over a module, I want these highlights to be active as well, which should be doable. It should be pretty doable. Good, so let's go to the bubble overlay. Let's see how this is done. Bubble.execute. Repulse, repulse from mouse. Highlight 2 equals true. That is a bit strange. So apparently, I've already tried to do something like this. Huh. Okay. And for some reason, given up also. Well, let's try it. So. I don't really know what highlight 2 does, to be honest. It appears to be somehow related to stuff being selected in the editor, but I don't really remember what it actually means. Does it actually highlight stuff when you... I wonder. Does it highlight stuff when you have it selected? Strange. Ah, okay. It does sort of work, but it highlights everything that is connected to this module now. To the respective key now, which is not really what I want. Okay, and apparently when I select stuff, these are also shown. Okay, good. Okay, so I'm guessing highlight 2 might be the way in this case. Okay, so apparently highlight 2 does exist, and it is already doing what we want, but it was only doing it for the selected modules and not for modules which you just happen to hover over. I think would be nice. Basically, I think I disabled it because it looked too confusing. But that was back when you only had a single view mode for the editor, and when you couldn't, disable it. But if you have to say enabled it, I think. Okay, it's not working. Then I think it would look would should be nice. Highlight 2. Okay. Doesn't work like that. Two is true. Okay, F. Okay, I guess we have to check it here again. Contains. Actually, this should work like this too. We don't need to check if it's null or not. Well, actually, we do. Hello, Night Stalker. Okay, some game UI for the past week. Okay. I'm not really sure if I can help you too much, but I can definitely have a look. So just send a link or so, and we can have a look. Highlight 2 function for this. I'm sort of confused now. Oh, actually, this is also sort of counteracting it. second, I'm just going to check this first. I think this is not the way to go. HL is highlight or I think it looks pretty good. I think it's very, you know, it's like this modern UI approach, where it's very minimalistic and very unintrusive. I sort of wonder if it would look to have like a very very slight sort of separation, like a little, like a very slight border around these to have them a little separated, but otherwise I do like it. I do like it. Oh, okay, sorry, stupid, that's actually what you've just written as well. Oh, I'm an idiot. I'm an idiot. It's not this, but module equals get module under mouse. Okay. That was stupid. Alright, but that should fix it. What kind of game are you working on, Night Stalker? Is it going to be like an FPS, like Far Cry? I think the in-game art style also has a lot to do with what type of UI looks good and what might be disturbing or might not be. I mean, for example, if you have like a really minimalistic look, like I don't know, Monument Valley or we have like a lot of flat surfaces, and in that case you may not even need a border, because it might look, you know, separated enough anyway. Alright, that sort of works, I think. It's a bit Yep. Good. So now you can hover over the modules and have the commands highlighted. You can select a module, you can Okay, you select multiple modules, which may be a bit confusing. Or you can hover over these bubbles and have the modules highlighted, which is really nice. Right. FPS survival, okay.
Galaxy map initialized.
Okay, coming back to this. So basically, Tesla gun, okay. Tesla gun is assigned to space and 5. Okay. Let's test. So I mean on my keyboard it is 5, but nice ship, I have to say. But we're not here to appreciate the ship, we are here to find out why it stops shooting at some point. Basically, the whole thing we've just done was just to find out how to control this ship. So let's go back to see how to reproduce the bug. Okay, the Tesla gun will stop working after 1 to 2 missions. Choose exploration game, choose a mission, complete both mission objectives, and use jump kit to complete. Competitive battle royale. Sounds good. So a little bit like DayZ, I guess, or how is this one called? Rust or so? Dust Rust? I think you know what I mean. The one where you also like a caveman crafting stuff and so. Okay. So I'm sort of going to try to fix this bug without actually playing a few missions, because it's just a bit complicated to reproduce, I think. Let's just see what could cause the Tesla gun to not fire. There's actually a firework going on outside. I don't really know what they are celebrating, but sounds good. Thank you. Okay, so based on what the player has written, I'm going to assume that the Tesla gun is sort of going into a certain state, which makes it hard for, or which prevents it from firing once it gets in that state. So I'm sort of looking for stuff which is consistent. Okay, we have branches, which are, however, reset, or they should be reset after each mission, I think. Right. I think I've watched the first two or three Hunger Games movies. I think I've watched the first two. It's a pretty good show, I think. I think I sort of see where you're going with the game, right? Definitely sounds interesting. Interesting. Okay, I'm actually going to ask for more information on this bug. I'm not really sure if I can fix it at this point. Okay, let me just have a look if there are any errors which have occurred here. There were not. And yeah, I think that is pretty much going to be it for today. Like I said, it's really, really hot in here, and I'm sort of exhausted, honestly. But I think we've actually done a lot of stuff today. I think the Keyview mode is a real improvement. The persistent galaxy shop is nice. And the bug fixes, which we have done here, are also very nice. Alright. Good. So, let's deploy everything and let's post it in the forum. Thank you, Night Stalker. Good luck for your test tomorrow. Or good luck for your class tomorrow, I should say. And why is why Oh, actually, we forgot to update the list, so we're going to have to do the deployment again. Wow. Improved. Assistant shops and bug fixes. Basically, I don't want all the updates to be like to be like have just bug fix in their titles. I think that would be sort of stupid. All right, so yeah, I'm going to do the deployment. So the patch should be live in like 10 minutes or so. And yeah, so that pretty much concludes my stream for today. Like I said, unfortunately, there will be no streams in the upcoming 2 weeks, but I think I'm going to make one more progress report video at the end of the week, so stay tuned for that. And also, in case you haven't bought the game yet, you might want to take a look at the store tomorrow because there is going to be a bit of a sale promotion. So if you want to save a few bucks on it, go ahead. I hope it's not war. I think it's just the fireworks, and I'm going to take a look in a second. All right. Take care. And yeah, goodbye. See you next time.